The former president calls it like he sees it. His dismissal, he says, is nothing less than a coup.
We are totally clear. This has been a legislative coup d'etat against the people's will.
And his anger is not just limited to those that ousted him, but directed at those that replaced him.
This is a fake government. The citizens don't accept it. It is a government that altered the republic's institutionalism.
These words are in stark contrast to just days earlier, when he told his nation he would respect the outcome of the Senate's decision. Now he's fighting back. He set up an alternative government and says he will attend an upcoming regional summit as the country's legitimate leader. And he has the support of his neighbors. Venezuelan President Hugo Chavez also weighed in, threatening to cut oil exports to the country.
Retiramos al embajador.
We are calling the ambassador back. We do not recognize that government. We are also cancelling the oil shipments.
That oil ban could really hurt Paraguay, which is now becoming increasingly isolated. Almost all of its neighbors have reacted to his dismissal, some, like Chile, more forthright than others.
We estimate the due process and the right to a proper defense, which are included in the Paraguayan constitution, were not properly respected.
Lugo was elected 4 years ago on the promise of land reform and breaking the hold of the Colorado Party, which held power for 61 years. His latest words mean the scene is now set for more political turmoil in the country. Imran Khan, Al Jazeera.